Northampton High School students are visual artists, musicians, singers, actors, directors, scenic artists, and craftspeople. In addition to their academic studies, they produce beautiful, daring, thought-provoking, and transcendent work. For many students, the arts are the best part of their lives, the reason they come to school each day. The teachers in the Fine and Performing Arts Department are passionate mentors. They teach, challenge, and inspire our students, cultivating dedicated, confident, and courageous artists. The faculty prepare our students to become professional artists or to thrive in other fields, with lives enriched by art. It's no surprise that in lean school budgets, the fine and performing arts suffer. Our teachers do exceptional work with significantly limited resources, equipment, and supplies. This year, on Valley Gives Day, the Northampton High School PTO is raising money for the NHS Fine and Performing Arts. Please, give generously so that every artist in the NHS community has the opportunity to shine.
Loving him is like driving a new Maserati down a dead end street. Faster than the wind, passionate as sin, ending so suddenly. Loving him is like trying to change your mind.
Losing him was blue like I never known. Missing him was dark gray all alone. Forgetting him was like trying to know. Houston has been very kind to let us use his house. David, we rely on him to shred.
Galen.
Sometimes the cymbals are kind of loud.
I'd like to try to be as serious as possible for the next 3 months and really get like some good originals and then be able to perform.
I created the band at the end of sophomore year with my friend David Plotkin. We were talking and we realized we both played an instrument and we had a disinterest in taking that farther and creating a band.
And we talked to Emmett White.
I still remember the day that I was just peeking over Jason's shoulders at sophomore year, looking at his schedule, and I was like, oh, well, Jazz Workshop. What do you play? And I was like, I play bass guitar. And Jason very nicely let me be a part of this wonderful musical venture.
Last year, Jason came to me one day. They had another, a previous drummer who was a senior last year, and then who then left the group. So he came to me and he's like, hey, you want to be part of this band? And I wasn't really sure whether I was really part of the band at first, but then it kind of picked up steam and I just kind of became one of the main members of the group.
The first performance for this band was, I think, the Three County Fair, but it wasn't this band, it was the band with Megan. We didn't sound good, but it was fun. I wouldn't say we've really played gigs. Our repertoire isn't quite big enough, and we've never really gotten around to trying to find places to play.
Well, we performed once at the high school Battle of the Bands.
Performed at the Tri-County Fair Battle of the Bands last summer, where we did pretty well, though our lack of original songs did kind of drag us down.
And I'm hoping to perform in the future, maybe downtown, or Flywheel in East Hampton, just so we can get out there more and get that experience of performing. We realize we're really bad at staying on topic. When we're trying to practice, we always go on some like other tangent.
A lot of the time we go off in random directions. We noodle around, play different songs and stuff that we're not actually doing as a band. So we're always off topic.
Pansexual means you're attracted
to everything.
There's a difference between sexuality and gender.
You identify as
all Kenneth Bryant! God!
I sort of wanted to go more in like the pop punk direction, maybe some prog rock influences. David and Jason have been trying to take the band more in like in a classic soulful rock direction, but as the bassist, it's my responsibility to keep it edgy. So I try to interject it with a little bit more of that, like, you know, punk ethos. I really like slapping the bass mum, as they say, I guess, in Jamaica. And so Flea from Red Hot Chili Peppers is what maybe the bassist that everybody thinks of. But there's also, you know, Fieldy from Korn. For me, Ryan Martini from Mudvayne, I always really liked, especially his bass playing on LD50. And he would always make these crazy faces when performing. And I kind of do that too to some degree, just because, you know, you gotta have fun when you're performing. And the people have fun.
With four main members, that means we have four different schedules, and it's really hard to find a time that all works for everybody. And we need that practice, because individually we're all fairly good, I'd say. But like, a band's being all synchronized together, and getting that synchronicity is really hard unless you can all practice together.
Let's just say that I think sometimes as a group, we all need to listen a little bit more to one another. We need to work on cohesiveness in general.
Song we wrote, we actually decided as we were writing it that we were going to write something upbeat and peppy, and so we decided we'd write a song that was actually about the song itself, but we framed it as if it was about a girl, and we did use some experiences we've had in the past to sort of create that.
I recorded at Eastworks. My guitar teacher has a recording studio, so that's where we recorded our original.
The process was actually surprisingly smooth and easy. I thought it would be a little more difficult. Jason sang in another mic in another room so we could hear where we were in the song.
We're going round around in circles again. Well, you're crazy.
And then after that, I recorded the lead guitar.
I think I'm gonna mix the track.
Members of the band are all seniors besides myself, without me leaving.
Band pretty much ends in June.
We've definitely like grown as a group, you know, become better at playing with each other.
Rocking out. I mean, that's the reason to play in a band, is to have fun making music. If you're not having fun making music, why are you in a band?
You're gonna wear that in my classroom? Go to the office. Just go.
Yo, Max, how was your weekend?
Pretty good. How was yours?
I went to a party over the weekend. It was fun. I met a lot of people.
You should come sometime.
Yeah, I don't know. Maybe. I'll think about it.
I'll catch you later. I'm going to class now.
All right. See you later.
Give me your lunch money, you piece of shit.
Dude, I gave it to you all last week.
You're worthless!
Yo, Jason, why didn't you answer any of my calls last night?
potato soup, tomato soup, corn soup, dirt, powerful soup. Yeah, I think that those are the deadliest soups I can name.
Does chowder count as soup?
No.
I'm hungry. Do we have anything to eat left?
Like food? Food?
Yeah.
No.
Do we have any leather strips?
No, we ate all those.
Right. What about James?
No, he's gone.
Right, the damn bug storms.
Yep.
I miss James.
Could have eaten James.
Yeah. Hey, do you ever go to church back when churches were a thing?
No.
That would have helped.
Probably not.
Do you think James is in a better place?
No. Definitely not.
And I'm bored.
We could find some cereal boxes, do the puzzles on the back.
You know that they took all the puzzles.
Oh, yeah.
What do you think happens after we die?
I don't know. I don't think many people do.
What is that thing, though?
That thing?
Yeah.
Probably.
Huh.
What is that thing?
Think we can eat it?
Probably. But I don't really want to.
I think James would have eaten it. Oh, it's leaving anyway.
Oh.
Bye.
Bye, thing.
I miss it already.
Hmm.
Kind of like how I miss James. I think James would have eaten it.
James ate a lot of things.
Yeah. What was James? Was he like a bear?
I always thought he was like two horses.
Maybe both? But a good friend.
Yeah, a good friend. Maybe like just a boy, like a bad, wrong man. How are you on your phone?
What?
How are you on your phone?
It's an Android. Still good.
Thank you. first, you know? Captaining for the ultimate team, running for president. But I think I'm cut for the job. Hey, who told you to stop playing? Vote for Xander, Xander for class president. Vote for Xander. Hey, buddy, I know they're making you eat this prison rule, but if you vote for me for class president, I'll get rid of all the meat products in the school.
I have a protein deficiency, I need meat.
No, it's not a thing anymore. Peanut butter. Down with the heteropatriarchy, vote for Xander.
Well, you know the election's on Friday, that's tomorrow.
Yeah, I know that.
How are you planning on winning?
Three words. I don't know.
No food and guidance.
It's okay. I'm Wyatt Guild. You might have seen my flyers around the school. I'm running for president.
I don't care.
Look. See this? This is a flyer. Flyer with my face on it.
I don't care.
No, I don't care.
That was crazy, dude.
Wyatt Gill, Xander Stone, and Gage Marshall.
Who's the other candidates?
Okay, Lambo.
Yeah, I mean, you called us in here kind of unexpectedly, and you know, my heart's kind of going crazy. Did we do something?
It's not so much what you've done, but it's what you're gonna do.
I beg your pardon?
Say what now?
All right.
Listen, you guys have been fantastic students here at Northampton High School. Educationally involved, athletically involved, involved in theaters and activities. Really what Northampton is all about.
I don't understand what you just said.
All right, we need one of you to drop out of the race.
What?
I know. I've tried to convince him otherwise. I really have.
No, you didn't.
All right, yeah, I didn't. You know, Brian really bummed out. However, you three have been—
Why, Mr. Lombardi? I mean, the election's tomorrow.
Honestly, it's this. Having three people running in an election at Northampton High School creates this competitive aura. We're not competitive here at Northampton.
So, which one of us is it gonna be?
Well, we figure we'd leave it up to you.
I'm just gonna come out and say it. Wyatt, you should drop out. You have the lowest polls.
No polls.
And you're not gonna win.
So what? Don't I at least have a chance at the spotlight?
Not when there's two other people that are doing way better than you are. I agree! Wyatt, drop out! Just like, drop out, man! Come on!
I wouldn't be saying this if I didn't have to, and I'm doing really well in the polls right now.
So is I.
So if none of us is gonna drop out, what are we gonna do?
I've got it. None of us drop out.
Excusez-moi? Come again?
None of us drop out. We elect three presidents.
Surely you cannot be serious.
I am. Alright, hear me out. We elect one president for athletics. That would be you. You organize the teams. We elect one president for academics.
Me.
I'll organize clubs and the like. And we'll have one president for, vegans?
I like that idea. He's got a point.
Alright. I say we bring this plan to Mr. Lombardi right now. And if he doesn't agree to our terms, we riot. On Facebook.
Yeah!
Listen here, Brian. We're all gonna win this election, and I'll be damned if you try and stop us.
All right, that's fine.
Everybody.